What's going on, you guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Stacey Will. If you've never been here before, I am super, super stoked to make this video today because we are going to go on my favorite ride in Colorado. It is Trail Ridge Road through Rocky Mountain National Park. It just opened for the season a couple days ago. So just so you know, it's June 3rd. There's tons of snow everywhere, as y'all can see. I'm currently at the top of Berthoud Pass, and we're gonna go even up higher in elevation, up to about 12,100 feet or something like that. And there's gonna be like 10 or 15 foot snowbanks on each side of the road. Snowbanks don't last too long once summer hits, so it's definitely kind of like a short season if you wanna see Trail Ridge when it's covered in snow. So we're gonna go up there today and just have a good time. So let's get into it, and then afterwards we'll go grab some food. We decided to stop for coffee before we went to the park. We stopped at Simple Coffee. It used to be called Lionhead. Really good coffee, comes in a cute little glass jar. And we also got a breakfast burrito. It's huge. Looks really good. It comes with like a chipotle sour cream. Mm-hmm. It's good. It's a good burrito. This is my first time in the park since the brutal wildfires of 2020. In October of 2020, the East Troublesome and Cameron Peak fires expanded into Rocky and burned nearly 30,000 acres within the park. This area is typically thriving with elk, moose, and other wildlife, but for now, it resembles an apocalyptic forest that will eventually rejuvenate. So we just got into the park. By the way, these annual parks passes are good. You have to get the America the Beautiful one. You can get a Rocky Mountain specific pass, but this is $10 more and it gets you into every national park in the country for 80 bucks. It's $30 a motorcycle, I wanna say, to get into Rocky Mountain National Park. So these things totally pay for themselves because you can get you and another person in, and I always put my boyfriend as my second person. So yeah, that was basically $60 right there on this pass. This is the entrance station. We're, I think, right here, and we'll eventually start going all the way up into the Alpine. This is all above tree line right in here, and then eventually we'll make our way down to Estes Park. The little belly marmots, my favorites, chipmunks, pikas. In 1929, construction began in Rocky to create a more accessible and scenic route through the park. With only 4 months of the year to work, it took 9 years to complete the 48 miles of roadway between Grand Lake and Estes Park. Plowing to open Trail Ridge Road for the season begins in mid-April, with an average of 42 days to complete plowing operations. An inch or two of new snow can drift several feet overnight. Some years, the park opens in May, and others, it opens in June due to late season snowstorms. In a matter of minutes and a handful of switchbacks later, Trail Ridge Road climbs 4,000 feet from the evergreen forest into the alpine tundra. On a clear day like today, you can see Wyoming from certain vista points and a few of Colorado's famous and snow-capped 14ers. 11 miles of Trail Ridge Road lies above the tree line.
I'm 5'4" for reference.
The snow melts fast once summer arrives and the road is open for the season. In just a few weeks, the snow will melt and give way to the tundra landscape below, as if winter had never happened. Even though the snowpack was less than what I've seen in previous years, it's still an out-of-this-world experience getting to ride at these elevations.
Thank you.
with its lack of guardrails, steep drop-offs, and adverse weather conditions above treeline. Some say Trail Ridge Road is a terrifying road to travel. But roadways like this that allow you to quite literally live on the edge are the type of rides I live for.
So you guys got to see Trail Ridge Road. We'll have to come back later in the summer when all the snow's gone so you can see it when it's normal. And then we'll also have to go down to Glacier Basin sometime when I can get a permit, because those are definitely like the hottest commodity during the summer because all the good hiking and stuff is back there. But let's go eat and get back on the road.
With heavy traffic and tourists lining the streets of Estes Park, we opted for a 30-minute ride down Highway 36 to a spot that's a little more low-key and that I always enjoy stopping at. Oscar Blues began as a brew pub here in Lyons, Colorado in 1997 and began brewing beer in the basement in 1999. In 2002, they became the first to put craft beer in a can, and today you can enjoy plenty of their brews on tap as well as a ton of different food options.
Currently at Oscar Blues Brewery. We took Highway 34 out of Estes Park down to Lyons. It's like a 25-30 minute ride depending on how you ride it and if there's any traffic. By the way, today is a Thursday and that's why there was like no traffic in the park. They are on a timed entry system, but I honestly think that there's just less people during the week than there is on the weekend. But anyway, so now we are in Lyons. Oscar Blues Brewery is here. This is always my go-to spot when I come up to Lyons. This brewery's been here forever. It's a huge building. You can see it goes all the way over there, all over here. They have an insanely long food menu. I mean, they have everything on the menu possible. We got crawfish etouffee and then we split a thing of nachos and a couple beers, like literally two beers. but all the food here is super good. I've had fried chicken sandwiches. I've had fried green tomatoes. I've had all kinds of stuff here. Normally on the weekends if you come, there's bikes all lined out on the street too, so it's very motorcycle friendly if you ever decide to come up to Lyons, or if you're coming out of the national park and just want somewhere to go to have a couple drinks or food. But I think this is gonna do it for this video, you guys. It's been a pretty long day. We spent a lot of time in the park checking stuff out. Like I said, that's my favorite ride to do in Colorado. I'm kind of bummed that the snowbanks weren't as high as they were a couple years ago, but that's not controllable, so it's okay. I'm just stoked we got to do it. It's the highest continuous paved road in North America. So yeah, definitely kind of a bucket list ride for any motorcyclist. But I'm gonna go ahead and just end this video right now because we need to get back on the road. So thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe, like this video if you liked it. Let me know if you have any food wrecks in Estes Park, by the way, because I always just overlook Estes and come down to Lyons for food. But yeah, I'll see you guys on the next one. Later, y'all.